We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Good morning all. We are continuing our chapter of internal combustion engine. So far we have seen up to auto cycle, how auto cycle works, but I have received some questions from students regarding terminology of in internal combustion engine. So I will discuss the queries. So first concentrate on the components. We are having first this gray color rectangle is a cylinder, and inside cylinder we are having piston. Piston is connected with connecting rod, and connecting rod is connected with crank. Okay, this smaller link over here is a crank. And look at the motion of the piston and crank, they are in sync. Okay, when piston is at top dead center, position of crank is vertically upward, you can say. So this much distance from center to this point is considered as crank radius. And when piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center, piston is moved from top dead center to bottom dead center, we can see the crank is in vertically downward direction, means it has covered 180 degree angle. So keep this thing in mind. While piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center, crank will rotate by 180 degree. Simultaneously, you can say when piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center to top dead center, it will again cover 180 degree angle. So in terminology, we have said that stroke is equal to 2 times the radius of crank. Now we will see how it is. So when piston is at TDC, means when length is 0, stroke length is 0, we are having this position. When piston moves to BDC, we are having this position. So this much distance L is equivalent to this distance, diameter of crank, you can say, because when piston is at TDC, we are having our crank pin at this point. Okay, when piston is at BDC, our crank pin is at this point. Okay, and half of this distance is R, radius of crank. So stroke length will be equal to 2 times this distance plus this distance. Okay, so that is why stroke length is equal to 2 times radius. And another thing, this volume over TDC is called clearance volume. This volume will always be present there. This is provided for movement of valves inside the cylinder head. So when piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center, this much volume is getting cleared. This much volume, volume between top dead center and bottom dead center, this volume is called swept volume. Okay, volume swept by piston while moving from TDC to BDC, means when piston is moving from top to bottom, this much volume is getting cleared. And when piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center, this much volume will be shrinked. It is not going to be zero, there will be always clearance volume present. And Vs, we can calculate this value of swept volume. Okay, it is similar to volume of cylinder, because we know that this cylinder, volume of cylinder is pi by 4 d square into L. Okay. We are not considering complete length, we are just considering the stroke length L. Okay. Because swept volume is volume between TDC to BDC, so we will consider the length between TDC and BDC. So that is why swept volume is equal to pi by 4 d square into L. And one more thing to keep in mind. In one revolution of crank, the piston will move two times up, down and up. Observe this. Now crank has covered 180 degree angle, then again piston will move in upward direction, then again in downward direction. So this cycle will keep on repeating, but keep this in mind that in one revolution of crank, the piston will move two times up and down. Okay. And as I defined the top dead center and bottom dead center, it is the limit beyond which piston cannot go. Okay, top surface of piston cannot move. So you can observe this. It will not going to move beyond top dead center. Again down. Then for another half rotation, again upward direction. So keep this thing in mind. Okay, so now we will discuss how a four-stroke diesel engine works. Okay, it basically works on diesel cycle, and diesel cycle consists of again four processes. First one is suction, then compression, then power or expansion, and exhaust. Okay. This similar kind of processes we have seen in Otto cycle. Okay. There will be a difference in ignition of fuel in case of diesel engine or diesel cycle. So let's have a look at suction stroke. So in suction stroke, inlet valve will be opened and piston will move from top dead center to bottom dead center. Okay. Because of movement of piston from top dead center to bottom dead center, volume inside the cylinder will increase and only air will be sucked inside the cylinder. Okay, keep this thing in mind. In petrol cycle or Otto cycle, we were inserting mixture of fuel and air, while in case of diesel cycle, we are inserting only air inside the cylinder. Now, as this valve, inlet valve is open, the pressure inside the cylinder will be maintained atmospheric pressure during this suction stroke. And at the end of this stroke, the inlet valve will be closed. So, suction valve is open, exhaust valve, condition of exhaust valve is closed, and pressure inside the cylinder will be atmospheric. As the piston moves from TDC to BDC, crank will make an angle of 180 degree. So if we look this process on PV diagram, it will look like this. Piston is moving from top dead center to bottom dead center, and pressure inside the cylinder is maintained atmospheric because inlet valve is open. Okay. So pressure will be maintained constant. And you can see there is some space over here, because this much volume is always present in the cylinder, and that volume is called clearance volume. You can also in this animation also, this much volume is always present inside cylinder. So piston will move from TDC to BDC at constant pressure, you can see. Then second stroke is compression stroke. In compression stroke, piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center, and we have said that and at the end of suction stroke this inlet valve is closed. So in this stroke, both the inlet and exhaust valve will be closed, and piston will move from bottom dead center to top dead center. So this volume present over here, or air, only air is present over here, okay, that air will be compressed, okay, and because of compression of air, its pressure and temperature will increase, and temperature will increase up to self ignition temperature of diesel. And near the end of this stroke, means when piston is about to reach at top dead center, we are injecting diesel fuel inside the cylinder. Okay. We are injecting the fuel with the help of nozzle so that the fuel gets atomized, so it will be easy to ignite the fuel, okay, and burning will be efficient. Okay. So we are using nozzle to spray the fuel inside the cylinder. So both suction and exhaust valves are closed, piston moves from bottom to top, air inside the cylinder is compressed, so pressure and temperature will increase, and temperature of air is increased up to self ignition temperature of diesel. Okay, now what is self ignition temperature? Self ignition temperature is basically a temperature at which the fuel burns without any heat source. Means as soon as the fuel, diesel fuel, comes in contact with this high temperature air, the diesel will get ignited automatically. Okay, so that is self ignition temperature. And near the end of the stroke, we are injecting diesel. Okay, so if we look this on PV diagram, this process will look like this. Piston is moving from bottom dead center to top dead center, so volume is decreasing. And because of compression, pressure is increasing. So the process looks like this. Next stroke is power or expansion stroke. In diesel cycle, the rate of fuel injection is such that during combustion, constant pressure will be maintained. We have seen that we have started the supply of fuel at the end of compression stroke. Okay. And we are continuing the supply of fuel for some period of time when piston is near TDC. Okay. So that combustion of fuel will be done at constant pressure. In this stroke, again both the valves are closed. Now, because of combustion of fuel in this stroke, high pressure and temperature burnt gases will be produced, and this high pressure gas will push the piston in downward direction from top dead center to bottom dead center. So pressure while movement from TDC to BDC will reduce and volume will increase. And near the end of this stroke, when piston is about to reach at BDC, the exhaust valve will be opened. So suddenly the pressure will be dropped to atmospheric pressure. In this stroke, both suction and exhaust valves are closed and combustion is maintained at constant pressure. Due to high temperature and pressure gases, piston moves from TDC to BDC, and mechanical work is produced in this stroke. Okay. Work is produced in this stroke, that is why it is known as power stroke. Volume increases, pressure decreases, and near the end of this stroke, exhaust valve opens, which releases the burnt gases into atmosphere. Okay. So if we look this on PV diagram, first we have started the supply of fuel at point 3, means near the end of compression stroke. And we have mentioned that the rate of fuel injection is such that combustion maintains constant pressure. Okay. So we have started the supply of diesel at point 3 near TDC, and we are continuing the supply of fuel up to 0.4. And rate of fuel supply such that the constant pressure will be maintained. And this process you can say is a combustion process or heat supply process you can say, because we are generating heat in this process 3 to 4. And after combustion, this pressurized gases will push the piston from TDC to BDC, and near the end of this stroke, means near BDC, the exhaust valve will be open. So suddenly the pressure will be dropped to atmospheric pressure. In this stroke is called power stroke because we are producing work in this stroke. In process 3 to 4 is heat addition process, because we are burning fuel in this process at constant pressure. Last stroke is exhaust stroke. Okay. In exhaust stroke, the condition of exhaust valve is open and inlet valve is closed, and piston will move from bottom dead center to top dead center, and it will sweep all the exhaust gases out of the cylinder. As the exhaust valve is open, the pressure inside the cylinder will be atmospheric. So volume is going to be decreasing and pressure will maintain atmospheric because this valve is open. So if we look this on PV diagram, this process will look like this. Piston is moving from BDC to TDC at constant pressure. Now again, after completion of this stroke, again inlet valve opens and this cycle will be repeated. Okay. So this is how a diesel cycle works. We have seen it for 4-stroke diesel engine. Now as we have said that in this cycle we are supplying heat at constant pressure process, in this process 3 to 4. That is why this cycle is also known as constant pressure cycle. In petrol engine or in petrol cycle, we were supplying the fuel at constant volume. So we have said that process is constant volume. In this cycle, we are supplying it at constant pressure. So this cycle will be known as constant pressure cycle. That was about diesel cycle or how a diesel 4-stroke diesel engine works. Now we will see the difference between petrol and diesel engine. So first difference is based on suction stroke. In petrol engine, we have said that in suction stroke we are taking mixture of air and fuel inside the cylinder, while in case of diesel engine we are taking only air inside the cylinder in suction stroke. Then in compression stroke, we are compressing the mixture of air and fuel in petrol engine, while in diesel engine we are compressing only air. And the compression in petrol engine is up to 6 to 10 times, while in diesel engine it is 14 to 20 times, means we are compressing more in diesel engine, or you can say compression ratio in petrol engine is low, up to 6 to 10 times, and in diesel engine compression ratio is up to 14 to 20 times. Next, how we are generating power. In petrol engine, we are igniting the fuel with the help of spark. Okay, we are using spark plug in petrol engine, and we are giving spark to the mixture of air and fuel and generating power. While in diesel engine, we are using nozzle. We are not using spark plug. Okay. In petrol engine, we have compressed the air and the temperature of air is increased up to self-ignition temperature of diesel. And as the temperature of air reaches to self-ignition temperature, we are just injecting the diesel fuel inside the cylinder. And because of this, the fuel will be burned and power will be generated. Next, in petrol engine, we are using spark plug, while in diesel engine, we are using fuel injector. As we are using spark in this system, or we are igniting the fuel with the help of spark, this cycle petrol engine is known as spark ignition engine, SI engine you can say. And in diesel engine, we are igniting the fuel because of compressed air. That is why this cycle or this engine is known as compression ignition engine or CI engine. Petrol engine works on auto cycle or constant volume cycle. Okay, we are supplying the heat in this process 3 to 4, which is constant volume, while diesel engine works on diesel cycle or constant pressure cycle. Fuel supply. In petrol engine, we are supplying the fuel through carburetor, while in diesel engine, we are supplying the fuel through fuel pump. Okay. As we have said that we are supplying the mixture of air and fuel in suction stroke in petrol engine. So to create proper mixture of air and fuel, we will use carburetor. Okay. While in diesel engine, as we have said, the fuel, diesel fuel is injected inside the cylinder near the end of compression stroke. Okay. So to inject the fuel inside the cylinder, first we are required to increase the pressure of the diesel fuel so that the fuel can be inserted in the cylinder. So to increase the pressure of diesel, we are using fuel pump. Thermal efficiency. Thermal efficiency of petrol engine is low due to lower compression. Thermal efficiency of diesel engine is higher due to higher compression. Why this is so? That we will look in heat engine chapter, where we will derive the equation of efficiency of petrol engine. Or you can Google it. Efficiency of petrol engine is 1 minus 1 upon R raised to gamma minus 1. So compression ratio R, value of R will be present in equation of efficiency of petrol and diesel engine, and based on the value of R, we can say that for petrol engine, thermal efficiency is low as compared to diesel engine. Weight of engine. Petrol engines are generally lighter while diesel engines are heavier. Because we have to sustain higher pressure in diesel engine, we will use heavy parts. Starting of engine. Easy starting in cold weather, difficult in cold weather. Okay. Why this is so? In petrol engine, we are igniting the fuel by spark plug. Okay. So it doesn't matter whether the condition is cold or hot. Okay. We are igniting it with spark. By diesel engine, we are compressing the air so that its temperature reaches to self-ignition temperature of diesel. Okay. So in cold weather, the temperature of atmospheric air is lower as compared to summer season. Okay. So to take this lower temperature to self-ignition temperature, it is required to do more amount of work. Okay. To heat the lower temperature air to self-ignition temperature. Okay. So that is why difficult to start in cold weather in case of diesel engine. Okay, so that is the difference between petrol and diesel engine. If you have any query, then you can contact me or comment below.